use your own condition, right? So whenever you take your own car, so you have a new thing, and then the next generation you have a CD player here, right? And then there comes your infotainment systems, the touchscreen systems. So this is how our embedded systems are getting evolved in the automotive market. All the features available. Do you have only a phone name and a phone? Here you have a DVD, disc, or a film player. Here you have any number of things, whatever we have. These are all the switches, what you are going to use for the controlling the climate control systems or the door panels. So this could be your vehicle drive modes. And this is for state systems. So you have some state, such as state buttons displaying it, right? So to increase the volume or to change the song or to give some voice command to your infotainment systems. So this could be added to these scale-based switches. Now whatever see is something like what are the vehicle, what are the features, what we have in our vehicle. So after the upcoming slides we are going to see what are the next generation in this how we change. We have our tradition in there.
Think about what is there in India. We are assuming that Tesla is only in US and we can't have a board on it. Tesla might come, but even something better can be also done here in India. So let's see what are the new trends which we have in automotive that is undergoing a big evolution. Maybe the future job which you are doing could also migrate a lot with automotive. Initially automotive was a stream for mechanical. Nobody cared what an ECE engineer can do. Then slowly electrical came. So now ECE guys are doing a lot of things into it because there is a lot of, let's say, huge weightage of software and cloud systems coming into picture. So beware that everybody should know what's happening in automotive because the future job will be more or less linked with automotive. Because that's a commodity which we are using day in, day out. So let's start talking about some new technology trends which is there, and maybe, I don't know, when you try to make your future project, the trend will be to think what is there in the current trend in the automotive industry or what any industry which you are choosing. Let's talk about the passive entry, passive start system. So this is something very interesting where gone are the days where people used to carry their keys. So for example, I have to carry a key for my home, I have to carry a key for my car, and a key for my office, key for everything. Yeah? So now we are going to cut short everything and make one master key. That key could be your mobile. So go near the car will open for you. This is a trend which is there in future because in future we are trying to ensure that owning a car will become very expensive. So how many of you own a car here? That's also gone. It's going to be one touch system. I think you would have seen in the latest car. You press one touch, the engine is starting and keeping it running, right? So those things are coming under this technology. And you could see one interesting technology here where assume that you are coming from an airport or you are buying grocery from a big Walmart or some other shop. Your hand is fully with luggages. So how do you open your car? Where do you find the keys? No need. Just tap the bumper of the car. The bumper deck will open for you. That's it. Simple as that. So think, what are the sensors it needs to have? How does the car know whether it is a dog which is going to your car or whether it is the owner who is actually requesting to open? How do you think about the algorithm? That's the most interesting part of that. Next comes the tire pressure monitoring sensor. In the United States, all the cars are mandated to have a tire pressure monitoring sensor. So, if your pressure in your tire, I think all would be coming by this campus by a two-wheeler. So, once in hour, how often do you air your two-wheelers? Once in a week or once in a month? Once in a year? Twice in a month. Okay. It's going to be summer. Please reconsider when you're trying to add your app because the app will be depleting very fast during summer. Yeah. First of all, how is the air escaping from your tire? Is it through the walls it will escape or any other place?
Based upon the atmospheric temperature.
Good. Anything else? Okay. The rubber which you are using in your tire is not 100% solid. It has small pores. Very, very fine pores. Yeah? So, the air which you are pumping inside your tire is not 100% oxygen. So, what is that we know? We know 22% of the air is oxygen. The rest is nitrogen, which is water vapor, dust, etc., etc. So, that's what is going inside. And all these nitrogen and oxygen molecules seem to escape slowly from the cores of tires. And when the temperature increases, the reaction is still fast. So what happens is, your tire pressure reduces. If your tire pressure reduces, what is the biggest impact which you have? What are you losing? Fuel economy. You agree with me? Yeah? To say as a very simple example, assume this is a circle. Say this circle is about, I would say, 3 inches. Yeah? And assume this is going to be your wheel. If your tire pressure is reducing, then the radius is going to come down. Yeah? So you have to do 2 rotations to cover say 1 meter. Rather 1 rotation for I would say 800 or 900 meters. Yeah, for example. So that's going to be your loss which you are getting. So we are talking about the tire pressure systems and that's going to be wireless. See, how can you connect a sensor which is rolling physically with a wire to your AC? No, you can't. It's very difficult. So that's why we are using the radio frequency signal to connect it to your receiver. Yeah? So when you think about your project about the wireless, first think about application. Yeah? What application which you are going to use and what application it will help, not just a project. It's going to serve someone some point of time, also a learning for you. Please think in that sense. So for every wheel we'll be having the pressure sensor and it will say how much will be the pressure at each wheel. And then it will give a warning so that he has to change. So assume that if a car met with an accident in India, the first thing which we can break is the law. In abroad, the last thing which you can break is the law. So breaking law is easy in India, but it's not the case always. It will not be the case always. So if the car met with an accident, then they check all this data and they say it's because of low pressure in your tire that it went or you didn't maintain your tires, that's why the tire worn out. Then you will lose your insurance, your driving license. That's the next trend which is going to happen in future. So there's a lot of weightage for these embedded engineers who have to make those design. Good. Next interesting thing is, you can look at this thing called windshield-based information. This looks like some Iron Man stuff, but not anymore. This we are already having it in the car. The best thing is, when you are driving with your steering wheel in front, it's very hard to look down what is the speed in which I am driving. That's not good. So for that, what we do is we directly display the speed on the screen itself in such a way that it looks like it's something far off. Yeah? It's called the perception of vision when we design it. So this is very interesting part of it that you see here. Good. And next thing is for the Indian customers, quite soon we have this thing called combiner where it's going to be a small screen on which you are going to get this display about the vehicle speed. It's very hard to keep the navigation on your mobile and then sometimes when you drive the mobile water will fall down. You keep searching and a lorry will be coming in the front. What shall we do? Yeah? So in that case we have this combiner so that whatever there in your mobile, it's going to reflect as screen mirroring and then it's easy and safe for driving. Yeah? So think about these applications. Good. Now we are coming into the interesting part is about the wireless charging. Here we are showing a picture of charging a mobile phone. Good. But we are also trying to charge the entire car, for example an electrical car. That's the future. So that every time the cable has to run all the way from some place to connect my laptop. Come on, it's ridiculous. Instead, if you have a charger here wirelessly in every table, it's very easy, job done. So that's what we have to do it in future. And there is a huge loss in wireless transmission. So if you are interested to learn in your ECE about wireless transmission, then take care about how do you reduce the attenuation and the losses. Good. So what we look here is the hardware limiter, the electromagnetic field, and most important thing is this technology should also not harm the humans. Yeah, that's going to be a bit debatable thought about how our technology will tend to harm humans. So that's entirely a different story which is to be addressed. Good. So interestingly, we have also the telematics control unit. You know, what is the advantage of this? What is telematics? Anybody from here? What is telematics? I think somebody over there was having some thought. What is telematics? No? Just think about the name, telematics. Something which is going to be transponded for a long distance. So the idea is telematics will be like a black box for your car. See, recently the Ethiopian Airlines fell down, right? How did they know how the plane crashed? Based on the black box. So similarly, how do I know that how the car failed or how the car got crashed? We need the telematics control unit. So this will record every aspect of your car. It will ensure everything is good. The driver pattern, the driving pattern, how it got crashed, what happened before crash, what happened after crash, the casualty, was the driver wearing seatbelt or not, how many passengers are sitting inside your car, so many things. And the interesting part here is, once you get this information, we are trying to send this information to the respective hospitals nearby. I think most of the DE guys will have this project about fire alarm detector, smoke detector, then sending an SMS to GSM somewhere outside. Think a little bit more about what more you could send in your GSM, what more applications you can make it. And at the end, it's going to go to the web server. And what happens here is, in this web server, that's where we are going to send a request to the ambulance nearby to send for recovery. And also, you have an option here in telematics that you can yourself call and say, sorry, my car is not starting, can you help me? So this car will go to the service station and he will try to send you a recovery van. Cybersecurity, the more wireless and the more high-tech you go, the more villains are in the market. So every time you make something automated, every time there is somebody intelligent to crack it. So how you are going to deal with it? Automotive is something which you are dealing with lives. Banking software is with money, but automotive is life. So when you do something with respect to life, take care that you are making your system as secure as possible. So cyber security is entirely a different field which we have in embedded system. That's going to be the boom in the next future. So if you want to spend some time or spend some time on your career, think about cyber security. Because it will be mandatory that every software should have a cyber security approval quite soon. Think about it. So this is some of the guidelines which we tend to follow when we make something automated using embedded systems for cyber security. Good. So, the interesting part here in cybersecurity is somebody sitting in a very bad neighboring country can send a single line of code to hack a car which is running here in our Chennai streets. Awesome. That's the future. So how do we avoid? So how do we prove that somebody has actually hacked the system? And how are you keeping your firewalls so secure? It's important. That's why even if you take my laptop, if anybody steals my laptop, I don't care. Because none can recover data from my laptop. Because I have a secure access card, I have Aadhaar encryption, I have a secure two-stage switch. So I could easily write or erase my data later on if you give incorrect passwords few times. Yeah? So that saves my laptop. It's really something which needs to save your car. So, we saw about some interesting part of the car. So, we have some more interesting slides to come. So, we have any questions to ask. We'll spend 5 minutes for some questions. Yeah. then we'll go some more high tech things. Okay, then let's keep the questions for the last one. So we